Spoilers ahead. Be forewarned. I mean, come the f*** on. It was so obvious. So, I just recently finished Splatoon 2 Story Mode and thought I'd give my opinion on it. Let's get cracking. So, very much like the first game, you access the story mode by making your way towards the mysterious little manhole in the corner of town. You go inside, and boom! You're introduced to Marie, one of the Squid Sisters. She tells you she scouted you because a great Zapfish is missing from Inkopolis again. Seriously, guys, maybe you shouldn't hide your power source dead center in the middle of town for the entire world to see. Not smart! About a mission or two in, you are eventually introduced to Sheldon, who tells you he will provide you with weapons to use for your journey, but prototypes to test for possible future wares for others to use. Let me just say, I think this was the perfect execution to allow us to use more weapons throughout the game. Not that only using the Hero Splatter in the first one was completely boring or anything, but each weapon feels like it could change a stage's progression drastically and makes quite the difference. Some may work better for one level, while others may work better for other levels. It depends on you. Speaking of levels, let's discuss this level design real quick. Starting with the hubs, or sectors in this case. In total, there are 5 sectors. Sector 1 contains 3 levels and a boss, and the other 4 contain 6 and a boss. You cannot access any of the bosses until you finish all levels in said sectors. The way these sectors are designed is quite unique, with lots of different ways to get around to finding the next level. Some may be a little more challenging to find than others, but you'll be satisfied when you finally do. The environment also looks quite good and offers little mini balloon popping challenges to either get little secrets or just more power egg things to power up your weapon. Next up, the levels themselves. Each level is different and unique, offering a new mechanic or gimmick. They are kinda large and normally take at least more than 4 minutes to beat, offering a variety of different enemy types as well as more challenge. And I do mean challenge sometimes. It's definitely harder than the first game, that's for certain. So don't go in all cocky thinking you're gonna beat one of these levels in one go, especially when this little forces weapons on you for more research. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention that Sheldon requests a lot of the time that you use a weapon of his choice for research. Sometimes it will be a weapon you don't mind or fits better for said level anyway, and there are some times where you will want to break that little helmet of his because a weapon you had already decided on before going in probably would have been better for you. Either way, at the very least, the levels are fair and never impossible to beat. They are winnable with every weapon available to you. So, if you want to go back and try a level again with a different weapon or a powered up version of a weapon you used previously, be my guest. Oh! And you can upgrade weapons, by the way. Do that. Speaking of revisiting levels, there's almost no way you're not revisiting a level if you're trying to collect every sunken scroll, which I did, so I know damn well it takes more than one try to get these things. Some of these are very well hidden, so just take your time, be patient with the level, stop and look at every new area that you get to thoroughly before progressing. Oh, and a warning, you don't get any real reward for just getting all the sunken scrolls from the levels, so it's literally just for the lore and the satisfaction of being able to say that you did it. I also wanted to mention the kettle bosses. For the most part, they are really, really fun, and it's as simple as just simply finding the pattern. Sometimes it can get slightly intense, and they may do something to make sure they don't get taken down, like apply armor or more faces, but there's always a way, and it's always a blast. Next, let's talk about the story itself. Personally, I went in fully expecting pretty much everything that I received. With a game like Splatoon, I was fully expecting more focus on the gameplay than the actual plot. The story itself has you most of the time thinking, not who, but why. Or at least in my personal experience. I fully expected DJ Octavio's return, and we all knew damn well who was working with him on the sidelines. All in all though, I'm not disappointed. Again, this is a game that's gameplay focused, not story focused. So it was simple enough for everyone to understand to become interested in. Even though some of the things were a little cliche and cheesy here and there, I still had just about no issues or complaints. Well, maybe except next time, hide the main secret of the final boss a little bit better, guys, come on! And finally, the final boss. The first half of the boss was a little bit rehashed, what with gunning the moving fists back at him. As a matter of fact, that was pretty much the whole fight. His moveset changed only slightly throughout the first half, whenever you'd hit him out of his butt thing. Also, I say him a lot because I didn't really feel like Kali added too much to that fight besides being Octavio's hype man. Overall, the first half was decent. The second half was actually kinda epic, not gonna lie. Not only does Sheldon hand you the Rainmaker, but you grind on rails while fighting him. Even though it's just a barrage of dodging and hitting fists back, it was still satisfying, epic, and fun. The Squid Sister starts singing their song and you start fighting. You finish him off by slamming the Rainmaker on his head, and that's it! Finished. You go back to the main plaza after the credits where you receive your hero outfit to use as equipment for turf, ranked, or league battles, and they look clean, by the way. Overall, the Splatoon 2 story is something that deserves a play and is pretty damn worth it to me. I recommend it fully to anyone who picks the game up. But even if you didn't, I couldn't blame you. Turf War is fun as hell. Speaking of which, I'm gonna go get back to it. Bye!